The new details of Michael Flynn's cooperation with special counsel Robert Mueller's team. Our senior justice correspondent Evan Perez is joining us. Our CNN national security and legal analyst Susan Hennessy is with us as well. They're both working this story. First of all, Evan, what can you tell us?
Well, Wolf, for the first time, we're hearing from the government just how valuable Michael Flynn has been to the special counsel's investigation. Over 19 interviews that the special counsel had with Michael Flynn. And we're getting some new details that were just unredacted in documents that the government had filed in federal court. Among the new bits of information that we have from these documents is that Michael Flynn was providing information to the special counsel about conversations people inside the Trump campaign, people associated with the Trump transition, including information about conversations they were having about WikiLeaks and about outreach to WikiLeaks, especially after those WikiLeaks emails started getting released. I'll read you just a little piece of what one of the documents says. It says, the defendant, that's Flynn, relayed to the government statements made in 2016 by senior campaign officials about WikiLeaks, to which only a select few people were privy. For example, the defendant recalled conversations with senior campaign officials after the release of the Podesta emails, during which the prospect of reaching out to WikiLeaks was discussed. You'll remember, Wolf, that this is a big part of the volume one of the special counsel's report, of the Mueller report. And we now know that Michael Flynn was the source of some of that information. We also learned from these newly redacted, unredacted documents that there was some outreach from people associated with the administration. We now know a little bit more about what that was. They were reaching out to Michael Flynn, to his legal team, and according to this document, was intended to help, to essentially affect what kind of cooperation Michael Flynn was providing to the special counsel. According to the special counsel, some of that information they did not have until Michael Flynn provided it to them, and that includes a voicemail from what appears to be a member of the Trump legal team, essentially talking a little bit about Michael Flynn's cooperation. Now, this is new information that could, again, shed new light on exactly what was going on behind the scenes as part of the special counsel's investigation into potential obstruction. And it underscores, Wolf, why members of Congress on Capitol Hill really want to hear from Robert Mueller, from people who were involved in the investigation. They want to know a little bit more about what went into the calculations of not making a decision on charging the president with obstruction.
Yeah, there's a lot to unpack right now. Susan Hennessy, what stands out to you? You've been going through this as the most important revelations.
I think one of the most significant things is the reference to documentary evidence that might be in the hands of Michael Flynn. So already we're seeing Congress and the executive branch gear up to have a major confrontation over what information DOJ is ultimately going to produce, not just the Mueller report in unredacted form, but also the underlying investigative materials. What a filing like this is really breadcrumbs to congressional investigators. If there is a voicemail out there, if there is documents out there that are in the possession of Michael Flynn, Congress now has the ability to actually reach out and subpoena those documents directly. The other piece that's potentially significant here is the Mueller report only included evidence that the special counsel's office thought was relevant to whether or not to either prosecute or decline to prosecute a crime. There's a big part of that story about what the campaign did, what it knew in response to WikiLeaks, other emails that they might have been pursuing that the special counsel essentially didn't believe existed, these 30,000 hacked emails from Hillary Clinton's server, what exactly the campaign did in that outreach. There's a big part of that story that certainly might be relevant to the American people, might be relevant to Congress as they potentially consider impeachment inquiries, but ultimately didn't make it into that Mueller, that actual Mueller report.
Well, let me get Evan. Evan, what can the Department of Justice do to stop Michael Flynn potentially from handing over information and documents directly to Congress?
Well, for now, Wolf, Michael Flynn is still awaiting the sentencing. As you recall, he has pleaded guilty to false statements. And so for now, probably he's under the control essentially of a judge. And so they'll have to go through a judge before anything happens. But certainly after that is done, the Justice Department probably can't stop him from providing any information that he has already provided to members of Congress. Keep in mind, he's not protected by executive privilege per se with regard to anything that happened during the campaign. This is executive privilege only protects you from information during the time that he was inside the administration for just those few weeks. So it's not clear to me that the Department of Justice could stop him from sharing information, especially as it relates to the WikiLeaks conversations that were happening before Donald Trump became president, before he was elected president.
You know, it's one of the aspects of this new information, Susan, involves WikiLeaks. It's a significant, potentially significant new revelation. Explain how significant it could be.
I think it potentially could be really significant. First of all, it indicates that Michael Flynn is one of a select few senior officials in the room. So the conversations that Flynn was privy to really were the inner circle, potentially Donald Trump himself. And so it speaks to the sensitivity and the potential value of Flynn's personal testimony. The other thing that the Mueller report didn't answer was the president's personal knowledge, right? What exactly they did in response to revelations and their own knowledge of what the Russians were actually doing. How did they seek to capitalize on this information? Did they have a plan to warn the American public? Did they even consider warning the American public? Did they believe that they benefited from this assistance? And so Michael Flynn really is in a position to fill in a lot of the gaps and the details in that volume one, which of course the special counsel's office determined that there were no additional chargeable crimes, but to the extent that we're using collusion in sort of a colloquial term, there were lots and lots of contacts between campaign officials and representatives of the Russian government, and certainly there was a lot of focus within the campaign on whether or not they could potentially benefit from help by the Russians.
You remember, Evan, at one point, President Trump, according to Comey, said to Comey when he was still the FBI director, you know, let Michael Flynn go. And that sort of fits into this right now, especially if Michael Flynn knew specific information about what WikiLeaks was doing, what the Russians were up to.
Right. Wolf, I think this goes to the motivation of why we've always wondered, right, why Michael Flynn was treated differently by the president. He didn't attack him on Twitter. He's attacked all the others who he believed were betraying, essentially, by cooperating with the special counsel's investigation. So one of the things that you see in these documents is the fact that you can see that there's this outreach effort, and they're trying to essentially tell Michael Flynn that, hey, we're all in the same boat. We have common interests. We'd love to know what you're saying, essentially, to the special counsel. The special counsel in this document says they weren't aware of some of that outreach until Michael Flynn provided it to him, and it shows you why they believe he was so valuable, why they've argued to the judge to treat him well, to essentially give him no prison time, because he's been so valuable to the special counsel.
I want to bring in Phil Mattingly, our congressional correspondent. He's up on Capitol Hill. Phil, this is likely to increase Democrats' demands for what's described as the underlying evidence associated with the 400-page-plus Mueller report.
Yeah, Wolf, I don't think there's any question about it. I think there's really three areas you need to pay attention to in terms of how Democrats are about to respond to this new information that's just breaking right now. And I think the first one is related to the unredacted report. A lot of Michael Flynn's information was redacted in the Mueller report that has been released publicly because it pertained or in some way was related to the ongoing Roger Stone case. This will underscore their efforts to receive the unredacted report in full. The other, as you note, Wolf, is the counterintelligence piece of this, the request for the underlying investigative information, not just as it relates to the Mueller report itself, but also as it relates to beyond just the Judiciary Committee, which is conducting its own investigation, the House Intelligence Committee as well, related to any contacts that the campaign or individuals involved with the transition team may have had with the Russian government or may have broached at any point in time. That would seem to line up with what that committee has been looking into, what that committee's jurisdiction is. And I think the third and probably most prominent, and one of the reasons I would be willing to bet over the course of the next couple of hours, you will hear people start to talk about the need to have Michael Flynn come up and publicly testify, is the idea of obstruction. Obviously, this has been a huge piece of the House Judiciary investigation up to this point. The idea that anybody from the Trump orbit was reaching out to Michael Flynn while he was cooperating with the Mueller investigation, the idea that there might be or there is a voicemail that reflects that, that is something that members of Congress, Democrats who are investigating, looking into this stuff, are going to want to get in some way, shape, or form, whether it's voluntarily turned over, whether it is subpoenaed. Those are the types of things that they would be looking to get as they continue to move forward in their investigation. So I think you need to look at this in three tracks. You need to understand that Democrats, who, it should be noted, have basically been hitting a brick wall on obtaining information beyond the public version of the Mueller report on all sorts of investigations, will be seeking to get in any way they possibly can. And I think it's also probably likely that at some point someone is going to be calling for Michael Flynn to come up and testify. Because remember, Wolf, Michael Flynn did not come up and testify on Capitol Hill through all the investigations over the course of the last 2 years. This likely moves him onto a list to come up at some point to address some of these issues that were raised in these new filings.